A very cool thing about Kotlin's if else and when is we can directly use it as expressions. For example, if I have two val, let's say val a equals to 10 and val b equals to 20, and I need to find out the max value between these two values. So what I can do is I can define a val c, and then I can directly write if a is greater than b, a else b, like this. So we can directly use if else as an expression. Now here, if this condition is true, that means if a is greater than b, then the value a will be assigned to c, else b will be assigned to c. And this is also an alternative of ternary operators if you are familiar with other programming languages, because in Kotlin we do not have any ternary operator, that is question mark and colon. So we do not have this operator in Kotlin, but we can directly use if else as an expression. And we can do the same thing with when as well. For example, we have val user type equals to admin, and then I can directly write val result equals to when user type, and I can write here admin, user is admin. And the same way I can define multiple conditions. For example, we have editor and author, and we have else, like this. Now if I print ln c and print ln result, then I will get the output. Let's see. So you can see we are getting 20, that is the max value, and we are also getting user is admin because this condition was true and this value is assigned to this result val. And this is how Kotlin is very cool and handy, and using if else and when like this becomes very handy when we build some applications and we have a lot of code, and it helps to concise our code. So that's it for this video, friends. Thanks for watching.